In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of ligament around shoulder joint, especially on the anterior part. In the first part, I'd like to explain ligament around scapula and clavicle. Let's look at this ligament first. This is conoid ligament, and this is trapezoid ligament. Conoid ligament, trapezoid ligament. These two ligaments together, it is called coracoclavicular ligament because these two ligaments attach on coracoid process and clavicle. Conoid ligament, trapezoid ligament. Let's go to this one. This is coracoacromial ligament that connects coracoid process and acromion. Okay? Then this is superior view. You are looking clavicle and scapula from the top. This is acromioclavicular ligament. Acromioclavicular ligaments. These ligaments do not cross shoulder joint. So these guys don't look like they are very important for shoulder joint. However, they are so important. Why? Because if clavicle doesn't move, if scapula doesn't move, shoulder cannot move. If scapula got fracture or these ligaments got ruptured, that lacks mobility and stability here, then that inhibits movement of shoulder. So these ligaments are very important for shoulder stability and movement. Very important. Now let's go to the ligaments and tendon around shoulder joint. You see these carhole tapes? These are glenohumeral ligament, but depends on the location, name is slightly different. This red one is superior glenohumeral ligament. Blue one is middle glenohumeral ligament. Yellow one is inferior glenohumeral ligament. Maybe you have seen these ligaments, right? But what is this green one? I never knew this until I looked up medical research. This is also glenohumeral ligament. This is spiral glenohumeral ligament. In this model, it's very linear, but if you Google this ligament, you see the picture of this ligament. It's like S-shape direction. That's why this is spiral glenohumeral ligament. This ligament has been described very a recent book. So maybe the old textbooks don't show this ligament. Okay, superior glenohumeral, middle glenohumeral, inferior glenohumeral, and spiral glenohumeral ligament. Okay, let's move on to the other one. This is coracohumeral ligament. It attaches on posterior part of coracoid process and humerus. This ligament is also important. If this ligament gets shortened, that inhibits internal rotation of shoulder. It's a little bit weird, right? Because it's on anterior side. If anterior part of the tissue gets shortened, it usually inhibits external rotation, right? Because it shortens this way, that inhibits external rotation. However, coracohumeral ligament inhibits internal rotation. This is very interesting. Okay. Now, what is this one? This is not ligament. It is tendon of biceps brachii. This is also important because tendon of biceps brachii kind of penetrates joint capsule, then attaches on scapula. Okay? So if somebody ruptures biceps tendon or somebody got complete numbness of biceps tendon, that lacks shoulder mobility and shoulder stability. Biceps is very important for shoulder movement and stability. Very important. So let's review today's structure. This is conoid ligament. This is trapezoid ligament. These two ligaments together is coracoclavicular ligament. This is coracoacromial ligament. This is acromioclavicular ligament. Superior glenohumeral, middle glenohumeral, inferior glenohumeral, and spiral glenohumeral. This is coracohumeral ligament. And this is biceps tendon. You know, shoulder joint is very, very complicated structure. However, understanding these supportive system is very, very important. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.